One of the best ways to catch these grander makos, or really any makos, is use some of their natural prey as bait.
But Greg and his team are not shark fishing for the fun of it. They hope to catch their first grander, attach the Shark Eye 2, and open a window on the world of these giant makos.
Look over.
From the time we hook up with the mako, our number one goal is getting in the shark safely. So the procedure is fairly simple. First, we need to get a shark on the line. The next major obstacle is getting that shark secured. And this is pretty hard because they almost always breach from the water, 20 feet sometimes, sometimes maybe even more. Once we have the shark boat side, we keep the boat in gear because they have to have water flowing across their gills to breathe. But also, that movement tends to calm them down a little bit. We'll have the head secured near the bow of the boat, the tail towards the back, and that is very efficient for us to easily attach the Shark Eye to and release the animal very rapidly. Do you see anything yet?
No.
There's something right there in the water.
Heads up, heads up, heads up.
There it is right there. It might be a mako. It's a mako.
Mako.
It's a mako. Give me the line back. Let's go.
Come on, come on, come on.
Here she comes.
No, you want it.
Let's see what we got here. Oh, wow. She's a big fish. She goes under the boat, we're going to be in trouble.
Mako on.
There she goes. Take it off.
This mako is larger than any shark the team has ever encountered. It could be a grander.
There she goes. Tails up.
Damn, this thing's swimming. Yo, it's pulling very strong.
She's gonna break that.
Oh, I can feel it coming up. Can't tell. Should there be that much tension on it, Keith?
Let me see. Let's see.
She's still behind it.
This is where it gets real. Okay. Look at it. Here it comes. Guys need to watch out. She jumps.
Makos have been documented to breach as high as 30 feet out of the water. A shark this size could launch directly into the boat, injuring both itself and the team. As the sun sets, the fishermen are getting more tired than the fish.
She's about 100 feet away. 80% pure muscle.
Once the mako is within a few feet of the boat, it can be safely secured, giving Matt and Greg the chance to attach Shark Eye 2.
I'm opening it up, I'm gonna power it up and get the settings going, put it on standby and close it up right before we install it on the shark.
Heads up,
here it goes again.
How is that for a 1,000-pound shark flying out of the
water? Badass.
Yeah! 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 Stay back, stay clear. Okay, hey, watch out, clear, clear, clear. Watch the teeth. Oh, my head. Come on, play nice, baby.
All right, you got it?
Oh, yeah.
The team finally pulls this massive grander alongside the boat and gets their first glimpse at a true Pacific warrior.
Oh, she's huge, man. See those marks on her forehead right there? That's from a seal biting her.
Well, this is a lot bigger than we thought. It's massive.
As dawn nears, the crew secures the mako and takes its measure.
She's 10 foot 7 inches.
All right, guys. Here we go.
Okay, hey, watch out.
She'll knock you senseless if she hits you with his tail. She could kill you.
All right, Keith, we're ready.
Okay, you ready to free her?
Yeah. All right, here she goes.
That was fantastic. What a beautiful fish, huh?
Badass, yeah.
By far the biggest Mako we've caught.
24 hours after deployment, Greg and his team use satellite pings to find and retrieve the Sharkeye 2.
We're really excited about retrieving this. Footage we're getting from this is quite incredible. Immediately after deployment, the shark descended as the sun rose. What we think is going on here is it's self-regulating, getting used to being in the water with the shark eye attached.
For 12 hours, the shark cruised at depth.
The shark didn't do much during the day, but right around sunset, that's when things got really interesting.
The grander suddenly accelerates, rising back to the depth where Greg and his team caught the shark the night before.
After it rose back to the surface, it immediately seemed to go into hunt mode.
The Sharkeye 2 captures the Mako's point of view as it casually gulps down a tuna crab.
Typically, you think of these big sharks, such as Mako's, going after calorie-rich meals like seals and sea lions. But here we see it preying on a tuna crab. Why is it hunting these tuna crab? Is it just eating anything it comes across? Well, we really don't know, and these are some fascinating questions.